Hey guys, Chris from Harmony Turbines here. We are outside and above me, I don't know where my finger is in relation to the turbine, is our turbine that we have on the roof, our alpha unit. What you might notice if my faithful companion who's doing the video is able to zoom in enough and hold it steady, is that we actually have our generator, our simplified axial flux generator, on the bottom of the unit up there. And it's the first time that we're actually putting one out in the wild to allow it to gather data for us. Now we have tweaks that we're going to continue to do to the generator, mainly with the number of turns, the gauge of wire, and the configuration of the coils themselves, whether we make the coils a little bit taller or a little bit fatter, things like that. We are going to continue to iterate and change that generator as we need to get really to tune it or to dial it into what we're after as far as performance. We need to look at our voltage, we need to look at our overall wattage that we're making, and of course we need to keep in mind the amps that it's spitting out. We've fried a number of our charge controllers because the voltage was, it was just too high. And you've got this very delicate balance that you have to maintain between your voltage, your amperage, and then the overall wattage that you're producing. So some of the other things we're going to be looking at is how it does in the weather, with the heat, with the cold, not that it's cold right now, but with the rain, we want to make sure that the unit is truly waterproofed. We have the keyway up at the top that we have purchased a waterproof flange for it, and we're testing that now. So having it out in the wild is a good way for us to just see how that all works. It's kind of funny, it's the only shiny part now that I'm looking at it at this angle. The new generator up there is the shiny part shining in the sun. So we want to kind of just start seeing how it performs out here. We call it in the wild when we put it outside, but we want to see how it does in the weather, and that encompasses hot, cold, rain, shine, you name it. The weather can throw a lot of different things at you. And then ultimately, we're going to start using the unit up there to tweak our furling algorithm and begin to, in higher wind conditions, use the data to start saying when we're at the upper safe limit of our RPM range. So we're just throwing out right now that we're thinking of starting that at 200 RPM. And as we go above 200 RPM, we would begin furling in and then just hold at that state to see if we need to furl in any further or whatever. So our furling algorithm requires high winds to really test that. But I have the guys working on the furling algorithm. They're of course working on the charge controller side. We are working on the generator and tweaking that. And then on top of all of that, we're getting this into a database with our STM32. We did a video on the STM32 board being our new data, both our collection and our control module, so a much more utilitarian and robust unit there. A lot of things going on right now. We are going to keep sharing with you as we go through our development process, as we move through our R&D, and we're going to show it all to you as much as we can, like always. So guys, this is perhaps, when this video comes out, the very last day of our campaign. If you love what we're doing here at Harmony Turbines and you can get behind the work that we represent, then please consider investing and becoming part owner in the company. We want to thank all of our YouTube subscribers, our Patreon, and our LinkedIn subscribers, of course, all of our investors, and you, if you would like to become an investor yourself and get on board becoming part owner of Harmony Turbines, now might be the time to do it. Okay, guys, Chris, signing off. Until next week, take care. Harmony Turbines. We now have the power to change the world.